Okay.
Am I the asshole for telling my friend her parents bought her house, not her? I'm a 28-year-old woman. I have a friend who's also 28 who purchased a house last year. It's an awesome two-story townhouse, and I've been over there plenty of times to help out with moving, decorating, and for hanging out. As mentioned in the title, her parents purchased the house for her and her partner. I don't have any issue with this, as the housing market is terrible for buyers, so more power to them for being homeowners. I recently, unfortunately, inherited my parents' house, which is 3-bedroom, out in the sticks.
What's the sticks?
Just out in the middle of nowhere.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Yeah, it's okay. The issue is when we went appliance shopping, because most of the stuff in the house was old, we were standing with an employee who I had asked to recommend some smaller items like toasters and kettles when the employee asked if I was moving out. Just general chit-chat. I told him I was moving, and he asked whether I bought or rented, and I told him bought because it was easier and less awkward than telling him I inherited the house. He told me that was cool and began talking about toasters again when my friend cut in that I had inherited the house, not purchased it. The employee went quiet and gave her a weird face. I was kind of taken aback, and she continued saying, "Yeah, I purchased my house," and asked, "Does it really matter? I'm here to buy some kitchen appliances, not tell this guy my personal issues." She grinned and said, "It's just for the record," which made me more confused and annoyed. I replied, "Okay, then, if it's just for the record, your parents purchased your house for you."
Oh.
Ooh.
Clap back.
The employee quickly retreated. She was walked like, out. This is fucking weird.
The employee quit that day.
I caught up with my friend and said, she said I was a massive asshole for pointing out she couldn't afford to own without her parents' help. I returned with a similar, "My parents also helped me getting a house too, just in a really terrible way." That's morbid. My partner agrees with me, saying that she's the one that opened that door, but our friends are split almost 50-50. About who was in the wrong here. Huh.
What? Okay, so it sounds like the poster's friend is bitter.
Bitter that
about the fact that her friend, the poster,
inherited a house.
And that she had to
because the implication is her parents died, and that's the only reason she has a house.
Yeah, I know. So
it's
doubly terrible. What person terrible.
Would be bitter?
That's my point. It's doubly terrible that this person is bitter, given the circumstances of why they inherited it. But still, I think she's just bitter at the surface level because her friend got a free house, regardless of how, and she had to pay for her house. So to make herself feel better, she says, she's reminding her friend, "You didn't have to pay for that house. I had to pay for mine. Now I feel better about myself for airing this in the kitchen appliance store." It's an immature response.
My first reaction here is to mostly feel bad for the employee, for these two women.
What a day at work. For
dragging him into this argument about inheriting versus having houses purchased for you. Like, this is all kind of...
It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Yeah, it sounds like the two friends need to work something out. Because
or just like, why are you friends?
Or if why this are you, is the or way not you... work something out? You know, whatever.
Are you friends?
But there's definitely some issues between them. One's bitter, and the other clapped back at the bitterness, which is kind of like, I get it. Like, if someone insulted me for something like that, I might, you know, a reaction might be to clap back in a similar way.
Yeah, like I think that. The response of like calling out embarrassing or in public in the store, I guess there's maybe a little satisfaction in that, but I don't think I would do that, mostly because I would just feel so awkward about, like, again, dragging that like service employee into it. I would mostly be like, oh, this person sucks. Either my friendship is worth, you know, addressing this and explaining why, like, that's not okay, or I just don't want to be friends with this person.
There's also some people that think calling others out publicly, and by public in this situation, I mean just in the presence of a third party, is more satisfying because then someone else is hearing this fact. I'm just trying to like get into the head of the other friend who was like, well, you inherited it, so technically you didn't purchase it. So if they're saying that in front of a third arbitrary, you know, random person, it's like making a statement to a member of the jury almost, like as if this was a court. It's misguided, and it's like unimportant, and it's completely unnecessary.
Yeah, I think the poster is right. Like, I don't want to have to explain to every guy I'm buying a toaster from.
You shouldn't.
How I ended up
owning a home. Yeah, and what does it matter? So I think it's really just that the friend is upset, maybe a little bit jealous that they purchased their house and their friend got given a house.
I mean, if you feel that way after your parents bought you a house, that's pretty unreasonable, right?
No, the other friend. The friend who purchased the house is jealous of the one who inherited the house.
Yeah, but the person who purchased the house, their parents purchased the house for them.
Yes, sorry.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So sorry, they're bitter about having someone receiving a house from inheriting it when they were just bought up.
Maybe,
they both ended up with a house that they inherited, essentially.
Maybe they technically are on title and their parents just gave them money, so it's still theirs. So they think, I'm not saying this is correct.
Why are we guessing these details? Okay, I don't
know. I'm just like trying to like guess what are their brains actually thinking? Who cares? Like, don't shit on your friends or make them feel worse because they have different things than you, less than you, different opportunities than you. And this is all done, really, in an effort to elevate oneself. And it's just coming from a place of insecurity. Like, don't go out blurting, like, well, actually, you did this or you don't have this and I have this. Like, who cares? Are you friends with this person? Okay, well, then you don't do that to your friends. Simply is mad.